is on Faction.
Oh, yeah, Get Hard. The name of the fucking movie, Get
Will Ferrell,
Hard.
Yeah, that's some gay shit, man.
That was some faggot shit. I turned it off.
As soon as the movie started, that dude was naked.
I fast forward that part, but...
The women love seeing that shit.
I fast forward that part.
They love that shit.
But there was another scene in that movie where it was it for me. I just turned it off. They wound up being at some, like, faggot meeting thing. No, they have, like, people come together and shit, and they, what the fuck is that, blind dating shit?
Yeah.
Just go to random tables.
Oh, yeah, that speed dating.
Oh, yeah, he was teaching me how to suck dick.
Yeah, that did it for me.
Was that the same movie?
Yeah, that same movie.
As soon as I seen the beginning, I was like, I don't watch movies at all, but I was at someone's house and they was watching it. I left the room, man.
You look familiar.
It wasn't some 8-Ball MJG. You hear that shit? I haven't nobody listened to that shit in goddamn 20 years.
Big
that
old,
old, old,
JG.
That's some old
shit. That was Rick Ross.
Was it?
Rapping about.
Oh, he was rapping about MJG. That's the shit I used to listen to back in the 90s. That On Top of the World shit. That is wicked as hell too, man. Talking about nothing but a bunch of bullshit.
Yeah, go on and follow Woman to Combat.
Oh, yeah, let me get that, which is what started this woman thing.
Yeah, go on and follow Woman to Combat, see what happens. She get you raped, too.
Look at that. Micah 7 and 1. Excuse me. Micah 7 and 5. Trust ye not in a friend, put not ye confidence in a guide. Oh, guide. That's probably talking about, hey, come on, I'll show you how to go. I'll show you how to get there. Come on, come with me.
Woman.
Take you in a back alley and...
That's it.
That's what we're at, bro.
Say, keep the doors of thy mouth from her that lieth in thy bosom. So you don't tell these women shit. You don't tell them nothing.
That's a commandment, too.
It's a commandment.
And being in secret services.
Yeah.
What the hell you going to do?
It's the blueprint
of how to live. The little bitches be out there, and they get caught up. So they snatch their ass up.
Yep, you know
they be running on all type of intel.
That's why
I only... You know what I'm saying? Give it all up.
Yeah,
give it all up. You got some paper. I can draw it for you.
Yeah, man.
That's why all these wicked ass drug dealers, a lot of them get caught because of their woman. A woman like to brag.
Yeah.
If your husband's doing something, she want to let everybody know, well, my man does this. My man does that.
But that's funny how most how it works, though. He'll really put the spirit on those devils to let... The woman charge and shit.
Yeah.
Just so they get a spectacle made out of
it. Fuck y'all so damn loud.
Because we all know, like, they supposed to be experts at physics. You know what I'm saying?
Supposed to be.
Like, it's pretty obvious what's going to happen if they really got a bunch of...
A bunch of women. Some emotional ass women.
Well, physics, the word physics means nature.
Can somebody get that scripture that says, it's like after the scripture that says, I'm trying to think.
Give us some intel.
I hate them dark spots that happen.
Yeah.
Like, if I get that one scripture.
Right, in your mind, you think before you started speaking.
Yeah. You got the scripture in your head.
What's about?
Woman shall be counted as a dog. It's like that scripture, but it's down the board.
That's easy to find.
I think it's like.
Let me get the rest of this.
It's like a woman shall be.
Keep like the doors of thy mouth from her that lieth
seek out the enemy or something like that.
I think that's the wisdom of Solomon.
A woman that honoreth her husband shall be judged. What? I'll just read it, bro. I'm just going to read it. It's all about women any goddamn way.
I think it's up right here.
It's all about women any goddamn way.
Is it all? Is it in 26?
Sorry about that.
Luke 27 look good.
Yeah, 27. That's what I saw. Okay. Yeah. You can read the whole thing, though.
From up top, though.
Might
as well start at least 25.
I'm 23.
Oh, there you go.
Okay, 23 is, this is Ecclesiastes 26:23. A wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man.
Right, because, if you're one of these wicked, you deserve a wicked-ass woman. Hopefully she's fine as hell, too. Then she,
That's the worst.
Because she fucking 20 other dudes, and you thinking you got yourself a prize. You gonna get a prize, all right.
Yeah, you had a prize.
Yeah, you had a prize.
Then she gave you another prize.
She gave you a few prizes.
A few.
And then they just kept growing.
Chlamydia, gonorrhea, herpes. Shit. a new nigga sperm.
Then he get, then somebody's coming over to battle you over the woman.
The same, right, and he's, right.
A lot of shootings happen because dudes are battling over a woman.
Yeah, yeah.
The whole goddamn gang fight will break out over a woman. Oh, even the Battle of Troy, going back to the ancient world, was fought over a woman.
Oh, yeah.
It was adulterous ass Paris was fucking the king of Sparta's wife. They fought a whole war that lasted a decade or more.
12 years.
Was it 12 years?
Yeah. Damn. Oh, they got it.
Well, you watched the movie, you thought the war only lasted a couple of days.
Yeah.
They didn't really make it seem like it lasted that long.
And that nigga died too because that woman. What's that dude, the main character?
Paris?
Nah, the dude in the black.
Oh, you're talking about Achilles?
Yeah, he
well,
fucked up.
The goddamn adulterer, Paris, killed him.
Oh, like, yeah.
Shot him in his Achilles heel. That's where it comes from.
Oh, yeah.
Shot, hit him with the bow.
Yeah. That motherfucker.
Bastard. I think he even escaped with the bitch, too.
Yep. He should have died. He should have died first.
Yeah, the mighty, of course. Oh, my God. But you know, he's just a slimy little bastard, wasn't he? Starting a whole goddamn war.
Yeah, he was a little peaceful.
Yeah,
peaceful.
Yeah, he couldn't even fight his own battle. He had to have Hector do all his dirty work.
Then
Hector
a badass
ended up
movie.
Getting killed for his brother.
Yeah.
That's how I hate that adultery.
Yeah, Hector should have killed him. Really? Your brother, look, you committed adultery. I'm sorry, I can't help you. You're on your own.
You
gotta
know.
Fight Achilles.
That's right.
I ain't fighting no goddamn Achilles.
Actually, he wasn't even fighting Achilles. So he got more better end of the deal. He only had to fight the king.
Oh, yep, the best warrior or something?
No, it was the king.
Big dude.
On the movie.
Oh, yeah.
Bitches.
That movie's kind of accurate, though.
What movie is that?
Detroit. With Brad Pitt.
Yeah, because he was getting his ass whooped by the bitch's husband. And that's when Hector came out and saved the day.
They show you that movie, too. If you watch that movie, Troy, they got statues of Apollo up in the Trojan temple or whatever.
He cut that nigga's head off.
It was like a black dude with braids. And Apollo. Yeah. Look at it. Watch that movie again. Pay attention to the statues.
But a godly woman is given to him that feareth the Lord. A dishonest woman contempteth shame, but an honest woman will reference her husband. A shameless woman shall be counted as a dog.
A shameless woman shall be counted as a dog.
Biatch.
But she that is shamefaced will fear the Lord. A woman that honoreth her husband shall be judged wise of all. But she that dishonoreth him in her pride shall be counted ungodly of all. A loud crying woman and a skull shall be sought out to drive away the enemy. The enemies.
There be two
things.
Right. You gonna get the black woman.
Dude, Esau, hey. You gonna tell me, if you had a group of Judite women versus a group of Edomite men, who do you think is going to win that battle?
Oh, shit.
It's over. Loud mouth hoe.
She'll scare away everybody.
They
you know motherfuckers are really scared of these black women.
Yep.
I mean, they're scared of
because they back down. Once she open that, because it's loud.
Yeah, it's loud.
They get thrown off from that loudness.
They get really get...
Me? I just let them go. When they finish, I go off.
Yeah, yeah.
It's my turn. My turn. Hold on, bitch. Let me get some Proverbs real quick. let them vent first.
Yep, let them vent.
You know? Let them vent.
Because there's no sense of getting in a screaming match.
Yeah, you ain't going to win that one. Because she can scream forever on nothing. Yep. On nothing.
Yeah.
On nothing. Nothing to have nothing to do with you.
And she ain't listening to nothing you say.
That's right. In one ear and out the other.
Right. If her mouth is moving, she definitely ain't hearing nothing you
say. What's that bitch on X-Men that be like screaming out like, everybody be like, ah, shit. You know, talking about loud ass mouth.
There's one in Marvel, too. DC got one, too.
That's the black bitch.
What is a dude, too? Banshee? You got Banshee and Siren.
Oh, yeah, when he's flying
Banshee,
like...
Banshee, Siren.
That was a bitch from Mortal Kombat.
But the one from DC, I like her because it's a woman.
DC? I'm trying to think of her.
The back of... I can't remember her name, but she's scout. That's her power. She's
I don't know a lot about DC.
Actually, there's two of them. A good guy and a black guy. Their power is screaming.
I'd have to look at it. I don't know a lot about DC, though.
Yeah, the woman looks like
that's
a
spiritual
power. Something like a school face. Yeah. That's what
she
get.
That's all she
get. Why the fuck that one up? Give a man that power. but DC got it right. Sometimes DC get shit right, sometimes Marvel get it right.
Yeah. I was just grew up on Marvel. You
know? I grew up on all that, both of them, Marvel and DC. That's just,
they're
attracted to spiritual power, man.
Yeah.
We're attracted to it. Some in our spirit just telling you, you don't have it. You won't get it. You an Israelite, you won't have in the kingdom regardless. Some type of form. Spiritual power.
Jake always is into galactical shit.
It's a galactical.
That's right.
Anything like
that's
galactical.
That's why you say,
yeah, that's Jake. Jake gotta Galactus. Go deep. You start talking about the planets and how much the earth weighs. Niggas like, listen, like.
Yeah, if you say dude, anything about cosmic and.
Shit. Damn,
what's
damn,
the word
damn,
they be using?
You deep, dog.
Oh, if you say anything about consciousness.
Psychedelic.
Oh, these my conscious brothers.
Right, my conscious sisters. Yeah, the earth and the dinosaurs like 33.6 trillion years ago when the black man, these motherfuckers be going off, man. Shut the fuck up. And yesterday on the news or today, RT said, on RT, they saying that dinosaurs is actually 10 million years earlier than what they've been saying. I'm like,
they never get it right.
10 million like, years
but
earlier.
There's this one
what
scientist.
They've been saying.
What was that scientist? There was some scientist that got banned. He got fired for saying that he couldn't find proof that dinosaurs were millions of years old.
He got him out of there.
And then he got fired.
Yeah.
I mean, he was an actual dude who was working, doing his, everything the way he's told it. And he said from his scientific experiments, he had to publish what he found, otherwise he'd be going against the scientific method.
So they get out of here, buddy. You're not with the program.
Get out of the batter, quick.
Yeah,
you're not with the program.
And he's like, I just published my results. The results said they was about roughly 10,000 years old.
Right.
Well, now, I don't think it was even 10,000. It was. It's just crazy, man.
When did the beast come in Genesis?
I was looking at
it. Let me read it real quick.
Genesis. It's almost impossible for a fossil to form. You got to have the right conditions. It has to be very dry. And because usually, if an animal or something dies out in the woods, it's gonna get eaten by other animals, bugs, maggots, flies, and it's gonna consume every last bit of it, and it's gonna totally deteriorate. So for a fossil to be formed is impossible. And they also say, how come...
So to be fossilized too, it's got to be in water too, right? Like,
yeah, well, yeah, it depends. Yeah, it all depends.
Water.
Depends on where it's... It has to be somewhere where it can't be, first of all, eaten. It has to be untouched. The ideal conditions are somewhere real dry.
Yeah,
or if it's real cold.
It's kind of similar to what you were saying about... Like not millions, but just a few thousand.
Yeah.
The square part of say it's 12 parts.
And they were saying
some divided in 12 parts.
Yeah, it's about that.
Animals
well,
let me got get took
that.
Out
12, 13,000 years, something like that.
Like let me get those, that. It's Ezra's, second Ezra's.
Like a lot of those prehistoric animals got took out from the flood.
Right. So yeah, because the Earth would be roughly about what 13,000 years old, something like that.
And they were saying that's why they got fossilized shit up deep, high in mountains.
But the thing is, too, they'll say this, too. They'll be like, how come we never found dinosaur fossils next to human fossils?
Shit, I've seen it.
First of all, that means they died. You gonna tell me people lived in the same dwelling place as dinosaurs?
Shit, nah.
That doesn't make no sense.
It has a footprint, like, side to side.
Oh, they do have footprints.
Yeah.
But, you know.
Oh, they sure do.
But you're not supposed to talk about that. That could have been... They actually explained that away and said, well, the dinosaur made it 10 million years ago. Then a human came along 10 million years later when the lava became reheated, melted again.
Yeah, they saying like
they say it wasn't really a footprint. It could have just been some sticks or something, some rocks.
I know this.
Here you go right here.
Ancient movies, they simply didn't dwell. They beware of that certain area. You'll get ate the fuck up.
You know? That dark ass world back then, motherfuckers didn't have to.
That's what I was saying. Yeah.
We don't belong, man.
Yeah, they had certain parts. Yeah, same like today.
That was a vicious world.
Even
back
today,
then.
Though.
Right.
You don't
that
go up in
Noah.
You don't just go up in the Amazon when you don't know what you're doing.
You know? You will never be seen again.
You would. Yeah, you would not come back.
You will not come back.
What goes in does not come out.
For real. Yeah. This is 2 Ezra 14.
You gotta be one of them. one of them Israelites down there.
Right. Second Ezra 14, the motherfucking Israelites down there that's still living like they fucking cave beasts.
But down there eating, licking magical frogs.
Right, walking around with the dicks tied with round sticks and shit.
And they just tripping on hallucinogens all day.
That's crazy, man. Israelites.
All right.
I saw shit too, doing some little research. It's like they still, but they wicked asses for a lot of Assyrian customs.
Yeah, they do, don't they?
With that shit.
You know what? I got this book. It's called the Atlantis of the Amazon or something like that. They were showing proof of the so-called old world that was found in the Amazon, right? And they found, like you just said, the Assyrian gods. They actually found artifacts of the Assyrian god that looks like a bird. It's called Nashrock or something. I forgot how to pronounce. It starts with an N. N-R-C-H or something. But they found Assyrian god idols in the Amazon.
Yeah.
I mean, I got this book.
I'm trying to think of the documentary, though.
I'm pretty sure, you know, a lot of them Israelites still took on them Assyrian customs.
They still, right now, still doing that same shit. Right now. Right now.
Hosea.
Ziggurats,
the
pyramids.
You know, the Mayans.
Hey,
Mayans,
after we come down off the ships, man, we're going to go after them.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
We're going to go correct them, too, after we come back down, man.
Because the Mayan pyramids, that's the same thing as the Babylonian ziggurat.
Ain't that bad.
You know what I mean? Ain't no difference. They get on top of the goddamn pyramid or ziggurat, sacrifice children, cut people's heads off, eat hearts.
Hosea,
toss their ass down the steps, like in that movie.
Man.
Apocalypse.
Eat flesh.
Yeah, they eat the flesh.
Yeah, so Hosea 8 or something like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, shit, over on the west coast of Africa, Israelites is eating their enemies, man.
Yeah, they eat
their gangs, that, you know, not their form of blood and Crips. Their version of the blood and Crips.
They killed it.
I say that on Vice.
They drink the blood and eat the flesh and everything. Yeah, the Vice got the bad video. They got a bad video on that. I found a long Vice video on it. I found the one that's like 45 minutes long, an hour long, whatever. Yeah, it's bad, man. Yeah, that's Israelites over there. That's Israel. We're going to go get them all, man.
With their bandanas around their shit. I seen the one where they in the background listening to some Pac and shit.
That's crazy, man. That's right. That's the...
they were up there listening to Pac and shit.
That's the popular evangelist over there. His name is Butt Naked.
Oh, yeah, but I seen that dude.
Butt Naked. He was part of that gang at one time. Butt Naked.
Looks like Loki.
Look, his name is Butt Naked.
What is that? That's a man.
Loki.
I don't know, man. That's an insult to Loki.
No.
They
fucked up in the movie, the Loki they got, man.
Loki was the good guy.
You know, they got the wrong Loki. The Loki that in the Avengers, man, that's an Edomite, man.
Yeah, that dude.
That's an Edomite.
Loki go way harder than that.
Yeah, Loki. That's one thing that attracted me to that. To Thor comic books was Loki in the comics. He was vicious, man. He was bad, man.
I'm gonna hit y'all something with Tate. You know from the Norse mythology?
You see that shit?
Yeah.
First of all, Norse mythology, I'll hit down that real quick. Thor is the thunder guy, right?
Yeah.
The word Loki, that's the thunder. What do you hear first? When there's a lightning storm, first you hear the thunder, then you got the light. The lightning that comes. The word Loki comes from the word that means light. It's like the lightning.
Yeah.
He's always chasing after Thor. You know, Loki, that's covered the same word as Luke. You know that? Yeah. It means light. Light. Same thing as the word Lucifer.
Yeah, my biological brothers.
Yeah, Loki was a half-breed of frost giants.
Half-breed.
Was he a half-breed?
Half and half.
I don't fucking know. He was a frost giant.
He was a mutant.
Yeah, he was a mutant. I don't know how the movie got it. He wanted to move
that shit. That's just gay, man.
They always fucking shit up.
Thor looked like a faggot. First of all, Thor's supposed to have red hair, not blonde hair.
Shit, first of all, Thor's supposed to be a brother.
Yep.
He started out a nigga. A nigga
they
god.
Just fucked that
he was
shit
a nigga
up
god. That's all they are, nigga gods, man. Fucking nigga.
Thor, yeah, it's the same shit.
You know? They just can't put it in their mind to do shit right, man.
Yeah, they never gonna
they
get that
right. Put in their
I got something about that new Exodus movie. It's like
they butchered that.
There will be no good there will be no accurate Exodus movie ever made. The Ten Commandments was off. They're all off.
I'm telling y'all gotta see the movie on Mary of Nazareth.
I tell you, about a Mary of Nazareth. Mary of Nazareth. Mary is Nazareth. It's about Mary?
Huh?
It's about Mary?
Yeah. she's the main shit of all of them.
You the porno? It's all about her.
Right.
I'm trying to figure how do you get a whole movie out of Mary?
I don't know, but they did, man. It is some blasphemous shit.
I didn't get a whole movie out of Mary.
Man, they fuck up all the movies. They made a movie about King David and had Richard Gere's faggot ass playing King David.
Richard Gere.
King David.
That's crazy, man.
That was the most
crazy. Hey, y'all want to see some blasphemous shit? And it's funny as fuck, but it's called Black Jesus on Cartoon Network.
I heard about it.
Oh, you want to see some? And it's exactly how the people think how the Lord is too. Yeah. It's exact. They don't go off nowhere.
There ain't no truth in it.
It's just a. It's like, damn. It's a documentary on the niggas in the hood. It's exactly how they think the Lord is. It's exactly, man. But it's some blasphemous, funny shit. Black Jesus, man.
Yeah, they look a little cute, kind of.
Charlie Murphy, he looked like he's sick, like he about to die, man.
Is that really Eddie Murphy's brother?
Yeah, that's Eddie Murphy's brother. He's been around for the longest Eddie Murphy been on. He's been on. He's been
I thought that was just a gag.
That's his brother.
He was on CB4, too.
Was he on CB4?
Yeah, he was a drug dealer that was in
jail.
That's who they was emulating.
Yeah.
CB4 is that
shit.
It's like, I'm black and I'm black and I'm
black, y'all. And I'm black, y'all.
Hey, that's some.
And I'm black.
That's those Egyptologists. That's all they do.
Yep.
They was on point with that movie.
He was a straight Egyptologist, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was. He was wearing the red, green, and black.
And they was always like, nigga, you into that. Man, go on with that stupid shit. Always talking to dude that way, man. Into that black consciousness bullshit.
Always trying to use big words and trying to sound intelligent.
Nigga, do you even know what you're saying?
No. It sounds good, though.
Yeah, but he always had that nigga around him profiting from him. In the movie CB4.
Called that.
That's a like fucking a little door.
What there?
No, this motherfucker.
Oh, I'm about to say.
One of his friends bought
that little bit.
Yeah, Esau, he fit all year round, man. He get out here and run, boy. That's Esau.
Out there jogging, man.
I'll be too stressed sometimes, be going, thinking about walking and running and working out. Too depressed.
I can't get the energy
to get motivated,
to get up and do it.
You be depressed, man. That depression, man, just takes over, man.
It does, too.
You, man, we've been fighting this for years now, man. Can you imagine what the apostles and GMS doing? Their bodies is going through, man.
Yeah, I be thinking my body can't even take the workout sometimes.
Yeah, right. Man, this is heavy on you, man. I can't imagine being doing this for 20, 30 years, man. Good.
You know, going crazy by that time.
Woo.
I'm already crazy.
Damn.
Mm-hmm. Look, the earlier pictures they put up, their hair all black.
Damn.
You know, everything's done neatly. But now look at them, they all grayed up, boy.
They
broken down and shit.
I got a picture of that.
That's crazy. I
hate the motherfuckers. The Ohio State Police. And you be seeing them in the cuts across the street going through the neighborhoods now. You see them everywhere.
I hate all these fucking faggot shit. Revelation 2:26. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations.
That's right, you get broke down. You get wore out, mentally and physically, man. But you gotta find that energy somewhere in these scriptures and sustain yourself, man. Get out here, man.
Even Paul said that. I can get that too in 2 Corinthians. Let me find that. I'll mess it up.
You just gotta keep going with it, man. That faith keep you going.
Yes, it is.
That's all you need is just that faith to keep you going, man. You be down, cause sometimes I be down like a motherfucker, man. Until we get out here, man.
That's what your text too. Your motherfuckers be saying that I'm saved.
Oh, Lord.
All right.
Are you saying
that totally? Because
unto the end.
Yeah.
If you're saved, if we're already saved, then why would we got to stay true to the end?
You know what I'm saying?
Make no sense.
Right.
He dashed through a door to the end, the same shot to save.
You about to catch a bus?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
All that money you make, you need to buy you a car.
Shit, I got a car. I'm about to put it.
They get a car and end up getting impounded.
Yeah.
That's our fucking, but these faggot ass cops out here. I just had to get my car out of the impound last week. Fucking faggots.
Happy holidays.
They're the enemy of their own fucking people, man.
Rest their own fucking
people. All right,
brother.
for the long.
They love to do it.
They love doing that, man. They have no problem. Faggot ass cops got no problem. They got no problem.
That's what I'm saying.
With taking food out your children's mouth.
That's another crazy thing to think about too. When that martial law jump off.
Yeah.
All reality, that's going to be Israel kicking in people's doors.
Oh yeah.
Laying motherfuckers down.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It is going to be the Israel dude. And they gonna do it with a smile on their face. They like it, man. They like doing the devil's work, man. Fucking faggot.
No conscience.
That's just some faggot ass shit becoming a cop. Then you getting people for petty shit. You see all this crime? All right. Oh, you doing rapping about that phone?
Okay.
All right, then.
Shit. Oh, don't worry about it.
Well, I know for a fact. I'm going to ask you.
Yeah, it's cool. I can wait a week. It
isn't
having a big deal.
What's up, man?
I'm probably dropping off my balls to
Paul.
That's
cool. That worked.
Let me find out
if you. If it's even there at all, I don't know if it is.
What's up? What's up?
I might have left my phone in his house.
What's up, man?
I don't need a phone. I'd rather not have one.
I'm trying to see if there was a ham item there. Here you go. Let me read this real quick. This is Daniel 7:25. And he shall speak great words against the Most High. It shall wear out the saints of the Most High.
Yeah, that's what they do to us, man.
Yeah.
They got paid
for it. And this on my Esau.
And they got to pay for it.
Damn right. Damn right. And wear out the saints.
You just don't wear out the saints and, okay, we forgive you.
Right. Shit. That stress is a bad motherfucker.
Thessalonians says that the Lord's going to recompense him.
Recompense tribulation for him and trouble him.
Yeah.
That's right. So wear out the saints of the Most High and think to change times and laws.
They did change his times. We ain't using the same calendar that they used back in that ancient world.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They say the calendar's so messed up. They say the one so-called Jesus was born in the year zero. But they say that's actually 4 years off. They're not using a lunar calendar. They're using what they're using now?
Gregorian
calendar. And before the Gregorian calendar, they used the Julian calendar.
It ain't even 30, what is it, 31 days in a month? It's only like 29 days because the moon.
It's all screwed up. You're supposed to just keep a watch on the moon and all that, and that's how you keep things in order.
Yeah.
That's why it's 60 degrees in goddamn December.
You know what I'm saying?
The calendar's off by at least a month or two. Yeah. It's definitely off. Go ahead.
That's for damn sure. And think to change times and laws, and they shall be given into his hand unto a time and times and the dividing of time.
To the times and dividing of time.
But the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion, and to consume and to destroy it unto the end.
Oh, my fault. Dude almost went up on the
floor. Yeah, that's what it sounded like. Somebody got fucked up for a second.
He almost got broke.
Third motherfuckers, they don't go out, man, because they can't take that stress of coming, especially like this time of year. Winter time,
man, they can't.
They can't. Their bodies can't take this, man. So they go right back to the world.
It's gotta be a sunny day with no clouds in the sky. Mm-hmm. A clean forecast for the next week.
They gotta be high out of damn.
They want to teach in the rain, let alone the cold.
Right.
It was raining, I ain't teaching.
A warm, beautiful day. That's the excuse for not coming out. It's too warm and beautiful. So let's go spend some quality time with our family, man.
Really? Fuck, you ain't got no family. I was just reading that in I was not Micah. That Micah was just reading. That says that the enemies are. Those are your own household to be your enemies.
That's right.
You know what I mean? The Lord quoted that.
That's right.
And that was in that Micah 7. We was just reading Micah 7.
So it's love, man. Lord, come on, love, man. We're gonna be no division. We're gonna be all together. Love.
Hey, I got a scripture too to back up. You talking about how we all weak and stuff. Right, this is what Paul said. 2 Corinthians 10.
Awesome, that sounds good.
And 8. For though I should boast somewhat more of our authority, which the Lord had given us for edification, am not for your destruction, I should not be ashamed. So yeah, the Lord. Just like Paul, he gave us authority to teach you.
That's right.
And to tell you what's right and wrong. Because we do have authority.
Yeah, that's right.
It's, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
We're here to let you know if you're right or wrong.
That's right.
Hey, that's authority.
What?
He said that I may not seem as if I would terrify you by letters. For his letters, they say, are weighty and powerful, but his bodily presence is weak and his speech contemptible. So it said, you know, Paul's bodily presence was weak. He was all fucked up. You know what I mean?
Yeah, sick.
Catching all
sick
kinds of hell. Yeah, even Timothy was sick.
Mm-hmm.
He told Timothy to drink some wine for his stomach, didn't he?
Yeah. Drink some wine, mix it with water. Shit. This is hell, man. Dying every fucking day. We wake up dead.
Shit.
Hey, you wake up every day, new.
You probably, your heart probably stopped while you were asleep or some shit. You
got a new injury every day.
Hell, man.
As soon as one injury heals, something else pop up.
I don't know what's wrong with my elbow, man. I don't all in here. I don't even know what the fuck it is.
Shit just starts hurting.
It just started, man.
I had that shit with my arm last year. Just hurt so bad I couldn't even lift.
That shit been like this for like a month and a half, man. I don't know what the fuck.
Yeah, I stood up one day and I felt some sharp pain right
there. Hit it in the wrong spot.
Yeah. And it started hurting a little bit ever since.
Nate and they camp or whoever the fuck, man, they ain't happy. They ain't trying to get out of here, man. They happy with them bragging bodies they got.
Dressed up. They look like the Foot Clan off the Ninja Turtles.
Yeah.
Wearing them ninja suits and shit.
Like
wearing that purple. That's proud wearing purple like that.
Woo!
They mocked the Lord when they crucified him and put purple on him. You know, saying he was a king.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers never wear jackets, never wear coats. They just want to show off the garments and shit.
It's all about appearances.
I never seen it in my life, man.
That's crazy, ain't it?
They'd probably get on you too if you was wearing some janky shit.
How you going off, man?
They'd be afraid to see you. Be seen with you. They got everybody lined up, perfect face and shit.
Doing drills and shit.
Man, what the fuck? Look, I was in the Marines. You ain't gonna put me through that shit again.
They got a drill video. Reading scripture.
Yeah, scriptures reading. They was all reading at the same time. They had like 50 people reading the scripture at the same time. It just sounded like confusion.
And it looked stupid.
It looked very stupid.
What the fuck are they doing?
Y'all don't know who we're talking about. There's a group on the internet on YouTube called Israel United in Christ. Look them up. They're a bunch of faggots.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Bunch of goddamn faggot doubles.
Yeah. They're like, oh, they're not faggots. They have wives.
They're heathens.
They're heathens.
They're heathens.
They're fat. You know, a faggot is a bundle of sticks that get burned up.
That's right.
Like when you separate the wheat from the tares, you got spiritual tares.
That's right.
You separate the wheat from the tares. Take the tares and you burn them. You know what I mean? Hey, y'all get that too, man. Let me get that.
Your motherfuckers don't talk nothing about Russia. Nothing about nukes.
They don't talk about nothing.
They don't talk about
all
shit.
All they talk about is Christ.
And the law. The law.
Christ and the law. That didn't make no goddamn sense. Where in the law did it say? Where in the law did it say for everybody to wear purple garments? Dress up like ninjas.
That's pretty good.
How do they claim they keeping the law when they got dudes with dreads? How is that keeping the law?
Lined the fuck up.
Lined up, they got dreads.
Those are worldly niggas, man.
Really?
Worldly niggas. And you can't say shit to them, man. You can't say shit to them. I mean, nothing.
Yeah, they just totally worldly. A lot of them dudes is cops.
Yeah.
They pulling motherfuckers over for what? Turn signal violations?
Woo!
What kind of petty bullshit
seat
is that?
Seatbelt
violations. You just stealing money out of people's mouths. You taking food out of children's mouths. Every ticket you write is taking food out of someone's mouth, man. You taking food out of a child's mouth.
That's right. That's right.
You make it so they can't pay rent. They can't pay an electric bill. Every little ticket, that speeding ticket, that's some faggot shit. That's some faggot bitch ass shit. Every speeding ticket a cop writes, man, you taking food out of someone's mouth.
That's fucked up, bro.
Yeah, it's real fucked up.
And they do the same shit.
And they got cops in their fucking church.
They do the
fucking
same
cop.
Shit.
Nate himself, the leader, is a fucking cop.
That's right.
What kind of madness is that?
That's right.
Fucking, there's no excusing that.
You can only talk to them, motherfucker.
All you can do is just pray that the Lord kills them and destroys them.
And
it makes a public example out of them.
That's right.
Like that dude that got killed 666, whatever.
Yeah, that dude got shot six times, you said?
Yeah, that thing was called like six, something about six.
Yeah,
six.
One of they dudes got shot. That was good for him. All they care about is fame.
Yep. 15 minutes of fame.
Fuck your fame.
10, 15
minutes. Like you really gonna get famous in the world for teaching the Bible. Are you serious? The only famous Bible teachers in America is who? A bunch of con artists.
Then they had like the bitch teaching up there when that dude died. That fat bitch, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they had that fat bitch. She was his mom, wasn't it?
Yeah, she was like
reading. The singer.
Their
son died. Got
oh,
shot.
Yeah.
His mom was a singer. Yeah.
She was like reading Israelites or some bullshit. I don't know.
Didn't you say you seen company speak with
her? She teaching.
Yeah, right here in Columbus.
She was prophesying on the street.
Yeah, so, she was giving orders.
Like, giving orders.
Get this scripture.
Get this scripture.
I was in awe. Like,
Joe 20. I was bad. That's crazy.
She was fine too, man.
She looked good?
Yeah. Big bitch. Big bitch. Pretty. You know, every once in a while you see a fat bitch that's pretty as fuck. She was one of them.
That's messed up, man. She
giving orders and shit.
She's your sister.
And she was walking to each one of them, going to the next one.
That's madness.
I was bugged out, man.
That's crazy.
Fuck that.
You can see she was part of it for a while, too. She had to be, man. Had to be, man.
That's crazy.
You fucking woman.
That's crazy.
Right. Here you go. This is Jeremiah 10 and 19. Woe is me for my hurt. My wound is grievous. But I said, truly, this is grief, and I must bear it. My tabernacle is spoiled, and all my cords are broken. My children are gone forth of me, and they are not. There is none to stretch forth my tent anymore, and to set up my curtains. For the pastors are become brutish, and have not sought the Lord. Therefore they shall not prosper, and all their flocks shall be scattered.
That's what happened.
Yep.
That's why all Israel scattered.
Yep.
That's why Israel don't know they're Israel.
Yeah.
Even the Israelites didn't know they're Israelites, like IUIC, people we was just talking about. Look at them. That's nothing but confusion.
Judah.
And after a while, it's all going to be broken up.
Yeah.
And they're all going to be scattered.
We can see it all, too.
Yeah.
That's the beauty of it all. We're going to see it all happen. I can't wait, man. Nate, 2016 will be something.
They just got a proud spirit on them. Like, they're so great.
That's what hype us up when it happens.
And you see, even with the way they teach is proud.
Yeah.
It's real, like, they're better than everybody.
Got them. They, like, got them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can imagine just them real, money, man.
Just enough of pride.
Them said, them motherfuckers is making millions, man.
I believe it.
Nate is making millions, man. They say he's making millions.
You know what they say? If you want to get rich, start your own religion.
Yeah. Making millions, man. I can imagine too. And plus he's C3, 501c3 too.
That's probably helped him out.
Woo!
All that merchandise they sell.
Yeah.
And you know the main thing, if you ain't paying tithes, they gonna excommunicate your ass. You was no longer part of the church. I guarantee if you don't pay your tithes, they will shame you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's a shameful thing.
They clowned on them one, two brothers that left them and then came back. They put the cameras right on them and had them apologizing and how they grown they were and shit. That's some bugged out shit.
That's some cultic shit.
Yeah, that was just two stupid motherfuckers do that type of shit.
There's nothing wrong with getting on people for, you know, falling out the truth.
Yeah, the truth. But not that shit.
Yeah, not that shit. That shit's a joke, man. Like, it goes back to that color purple too, man. That's proud. Somebody wearing purple. Yeah.
And
I got a scripture.
And that royal color purple is nice too.
Yeah.
But they make it bad, look bad.
You know,
man.
During the Byzantine Empire, only the emperor and maybe the Praetorian Guard was allowed to wear purple.
Dang. I was always attracted to that color, man. It's a certain color of purple, a certain shade of it that's nice.
I'm trying to think of the emperor. I was just listening to my audio, I was listening to Byzantine audiobook. Man, I'm trying to remember this emperor's name. One of the Byzantine emperors around the 5th century, somewhere around there. Some guy came before the emperor wearing purple boots.
Sure.
And the emperor was like, look, you gotta take those boots off. You ain't not coming before me wearing purple.
So,
that's my color.
There you go.
Only the emperor was allowed to wear purple.
Wow.
You can do that to the motherfuckers in the kingdom.
Color of royalty.
Oh.
I'm gonna do a word search on purple.
Oh. We're gonna have our wing with these hoes.
You know, yeah, you know where the purple came from, right? Who made the purple garments? Anybody, y'all know who made them?
Who made the purple garments?
Who was famous for making the purple garments?
Shit, I don't know what
we're the Phoenicians. They were famous for
them. Ooh, Phoenicians.
The word Phoenician even kind of means purple, they say. Because they took the shells, the seashells, is a certain kind of mollusk, or whatever they call them, mollusks.
Right,
and
right,
they got
right.
They killed them, they squished all the dye out, the snails, or whatever the fuck they are.
Okay.
And they got it from the shells, the purple.
The purple, right.
They had mastered harvesting the I think they call them mollusks.
That's what they are.
Yeah.
It's like a snail, water snail.
Yeah. That sounds.
They eat that shit.
And
too.
They say they stink.
Yeah, and that's a delicacy to them. Eating.
They probably did eat that
they
shit.
They love it. Hell yeah, it's like rubber, man. When you see them.
Dude, I ate what they call escargot before. When I was working at a seafood restaurant years and years and years ago.
Right, you ain't
know. Yeah, well, they forced me. They said you gotta taste everything on the menu because I was a waiter.
Wow.
And I ate that shit.
Fuck that.
I wanted to puke, man. I was sick for the rest of the day. Just the taste just would not leave.
Yeah.
It was not good.
Let me read this real quick.
Go ahead.
This is Ezekiel 13:1. And the word of the Lord came unto me saying, Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel that prophesy, and say thou unto them that prophesy out of their own hearts, hear ye the word of the Lord. Thus said the Lord power, woe unto the foolish prophets that follow their own spirit and have seen nothing. And you notice they don't have no like wild videos, you know, like shit they experience, like spiritual shit they see.
Yeah, nothing.
Like we talk about, like for
like
example,
super,
like
super deep.
Like we were talking about the albinos and they come through.
Yeah,
they don't talk
happen.
About nothing. Nothing like that happens with them.
They won't even go with no side stories like we do.
They can't.
They'll just go off. Yeah, we'll tell you about what we did yesterday.
And it still be spiritual.
Yeah. You know, we tell you, I was in the store, this motherfucker. I was watching this movie. I was.
Yep. There's no telling where we gonna go.
Yeah, you don't know. You don't know what's coming.
We don't plan this either. We don't plan it either.
Their videos are very predictable.
Yep.
We know what they're gonna say.
Yep.
They're gonna read Deuteronomy 28:68.
You notice that though?
Israel.
We don't plan it. Man, that's that living water, bro.
All they got is those basic. Same old shit. The scriptures are good to know, but all they know is the basics. Yep, basics of all basics.
Yep.
They
know.
They know Romans 9:13. They know. What's the other one's name?
I don't know what they know. I know they don't know nothing.
They know
they don't
scriptures.
Know shit.
They know those scriptures that you learn on week one.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Low level. They're low level Israelites on a very low level.
Yeah. They give the scriptures to anybody and everybody. When pretty much the scriptures is just really for the elect.
For the elect, that's it.
That's it. So they going way off. You don't give no motherfucking woman some. Man, these motherfuckers is bugged out, man. Giving these women these scriptures.
That's weird. All the women's in the order. That's gotta be set up, man. All them women.
You say that set up.
That's just
set up.
Cause I mean, if you in the truth, man, that's impossible. I'm sorry. That can't be possible.
And listen, they got thousands of motherfuckers part of it, man. That's why they're making that money.
Hey, you can read you can read 1 Maccabees, the 10th chapter. I mean, it's a long chapter. It's when the Israelites was making a deal with the Romans to help protect them in a time of war.
Right.
And the Israelites was speaking good of those Romans because that was before the Roman Empire formed. And they was like, look, these guys, not even a single one of them even wear the purple.
Jesus.
And they, you know, that was a good thing that they did not wear purple. That's a proud statement.
Right.
But where is that? It's right here, 1 Maccabees 14:44. Oh, this is actually 14. I don't think that's the one I want.
It's coming down to showdown time. Showdown time, boy.
Show.
Just go read.
Yeah, just go read that. You don't know about that?
You don't want that.
Just go read Maccabees 10 through 15.
Yeah, I got that one.
You don't want that one, dude. It's a little bitch. It's too
small. You can have the skinny one.
I take what the Lord gives me.
Yeah, she's a bitch was cute.
The Lord works in mysterious ways. You go home, she be doing everything for you. You wake up in the morning, your clothes is iron.
Oh, you talking about another nation woman?
Yeah.
Not the Negro.
Not that one.
Okay.
Not the Negro one.
That's what I was talking about. Yeah.
Wake up, your shit be gone.
He said your shit be gone.
Be gone.
That's a good one, boy.
Oh shit.
All you see is the TV ain't there, so the wire.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Front door still open.
Right. They ain't having come with this.
You
so
a dog
cool.
in the front yard, one in a row.
Leave that black woman alone. I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you. There's too many other women out there, boy. There's too many.
There's gotta be one good one, though.
Yeah. Maybe. I guess there is.
Harriet Tubman.
Oh, shit.
She's a strong woman.
Harriet Tubman.
Rosa Parks. It was,
that's a strong woman.
Get my camera.
Well, I thought that was a girl.
Nah, he getting it.
I know.
You know how many epic fails we seen out here of people on skateboards?
Oh, man.
How many people have we seen crash into that pole right there?
That pole, I think, would just sat there just for that reason.
Yeah, just for that. I mean,
yeah, and it hit that one too, I think.
Yep. We seen that dude skateboard. On that skateboard one day. He hit a crack. He just face and the ground met each other like pat.
Perfect connection.
Man.
Skateboard is over
there. I love seeing people get fucked up.
Yeah, that's.
Halloween, them dudes suck, man. The dudes over there in Halloween. They came over here and shit, trying to talk shit.
Oh, yeah.
It was ass.
The skateboard crew?
Yeah.
That's a good video.
They is booty, man.
Did you watch the video?
Yeah, I watched the video.
That's a good video.
Yeah,
we
sure.
Just clowning on them.
They're probably all dead by now.
Well, their leader was a Jew, so-called Jew.
Most likely be getting people, man, whether we see it or not. They be getting.
They do get them. You ain't gonna see it. That's like when we plant the seeds. We out here. It's like we taking seeds and you throw them in the wind. We throwing seeds in the wind and they just, it's like a dandelion seed. When them goddamn dead, the wind comes through, them dandelion seeds start blowing.
And they be lifting up in the air.
You don't know where them seeds is. They'll fly for miles. You see dandelion seeds float down the river.
Yeah.
You see that?
Yeah.
I go down to the creek all the time, they be floating down there, a whole bunch of seeds.
Yeah.
Sure. You don't know where those seeds are going.
Yep.
And they will grow.
Like a bird be eating all them fruits and shit. They go shit. Yep. They be flying and shit.
Because we can plant the seed. We can plant the seed and somebody else is going to water it.
Yep, that's right. But we can take credit for it.
You got, like you said, you don't know what effect we're having. I know the word of the Most High does not go out void.
That's right.
I know
you
that.
You know this is taking effect. You know it is.
I know it's taking effect.
We just know. Shit.
Plus, we got the internet too. For now, they're trying their best to ruin the internet.
Gotta love it.
The dude from Pirate Bay came out. He was in the news today, one of the founders of the Pirate Bay. He said the internet is ruined, it's broken, it's shit. And he said that they have lost the battle he said the torrent websites have lost the battle. You know what I'm saying? The battle against the copyright, Hollywood, they've lost against all of that. Mm-hmm. He said the battle's over.
Well, we knew it was coming.
We knew it was over.
Well, we knew it was coming.
I knew the end was near when Mega Upload went down. What was that, 2011, 2000?
You talking about Kim?
Yeah, Kim.com?
Yeah.
Was that 2012? Yeah. I can't remember.
11?
Back then, we knew it was on. It was that was the beginning of the end
we're
right there.
We're going to 16 now. That was a good 4 or 5 years ago. 5-6 years ago.
Yeah, that was a minute.
Shit.
It's been a minute.
And we got hyped up then. We thought some shit was going to really go down.
I remember we made a video about it.
Yeah, because it was some serious shit though.
That video got thousands of views and then our channel got deleted.
We made a home video on it.
Yeah, a home video.
We sure did.
And a lot of people saw the video, then they deleted our channel.
Mm-hmm.
Because that was some information with the way we broke it down. They didn't want people knowing what was coming.
Yeah, here we are. Here we are. I hate to admit it, man. I didn't want looking forward to it, but
I wasn't looking forward to it.
Shit.
Yeah. I love my torrent sites,
yeah.
Man.
God, man.
And I don't just use torrent sites to watch the new movies. I get books off of there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, history books. I downloaded a Cambridge book collection off the one, probably Pirate Bay or BT Junkie, one of them. But yeah, I still got it on disc. It's got like It's got hundreds and hundreds of history books published by Cambridge University.
Man, that's bad, man.
I got it on, you know, about 4 gigabytes worth of books.
Man, I wish I would have got busy doing more of that, man. I only got a few.
You can say Pirate Bay's still going. Better get it while the getting's good.
I can't find shit that working. I can't. Where? How am I gonna do it?
Pirate Bay.
Pirate. I went.
Man, oh, you got PirateBay.LA.
Go to PirateBay.LA.
ThePirateBay.LA.
I gotta put this on my
Try
phone,
that.
Man.
Because if you go to SE,
because I gotta get that book. I'm gonna order this book, man. Or y'all gonna like this book when y'all see it, man.
What's up,
man?
What's up, homie?
What you Native American, bro?
I got Asian.
You got Asian in you?
Yeah.
Okay, you a Jake though. You one of us though.
I got Asian.
What's your father?
Asian
Indian. Native American Indian? What you
Asian.
Asian.
Wow.
Yeah, you one of us though. That means your father was one of us.
And you're an Israelite.
Yeah. That's part of us being scattered amongst the other nations. We got scattered amongst some other nations. We started fucking them fine ass women in other nations.
That shit about to die.
You know? That's the beauty of these times we're living in, that people are waking up and finding out who they really are, man. What was I looking for, though? Oh, yeah.
We was talking about Torrance.
Yeah, I was going to take a note on this.
There's actually like 5 different Pirate Bay sites now. But the main, I know the only one I can remember is .LA, the Pirate Bay .LA.
The Pirate Bay. Yeah. Is that all one word?
Yep.
That nigga just tried tripping. What the fuck? That nigga crazy.
Pirate Bay. Dot.
LA. I know. Shit, I just used that yesterday. So.
Straight up.
Yeah.
You familiar with Alienware and XDA forum?
Alien. Oh, you talking about Alienware?
Mm-hmm.
That's like a computer, ain't it?
Yeah, well, some dude was schooling me on all this. I wrote down Alienware XDA forum that he does shit. He can hack phones and tablets and this and that. I'm supposed to go up to where he works. He's a DJ. The dude, dude sounds just like one of the dudes that rapping. It's a white cat though. He a Jake though.
Oh, yeah.
But he sounds just like them fast rappers that.
Say his thing, Columbus?
Yeah, he's a DJ.
Oh, yeah.
I don't go to bars and, you know.
You say you find him on the internet?
No, I ran into him.
Oh, he told you about the phone?
Yeah, he was just schooling me on shit,
man.
He was just schooling me on shit. He's like, man, I'm a DJ up in here.
Sound like all right guy.
Yeah, he turned on a little radio and he was rapping fast as fuck. I was like, God damn.
He's into computers?
Yeah, he said, come up to his job. He works at a bar up on Cleveland Avenue in 161 where I'm at, called